In this module, we are going to discuss about modified atmosphere packaging, which is commonly known as MAP, and controlled atmosphere packaging, commonly known as CAP, and different gases used in the MAP and CAP, and the different products which are packed under the modified and controlled atmosphere packaging.
In this chapter, we are going to discuss modified atmospheric packaging, that is MAP, and controlled atmospheric packaging, that is CAP. As we all know, air contains 78.08% nitrogen, 20.96% oxygen, 0.04% carbon dioxide, and traces of noble gases and water vapor. Food spoils rapidly in air due to moisture loss or gain, reaction with oxygen, and the growth of aerobic microorganisms, that is bacteria and molds. Microbial growth causes changes in texture, color, flavor, and nutritional value of food, which can make food unpalatable and potentially unsafe for human consumption. Storage of foods in a modified gaseous atmosphere can maintain quality and extend product shelf life by slowing chemical and biochemical deteriorative reactions and by slowing or preventing the growth of spoilage organisms. Modified atmosphere packaging, MAP, is defined as the packaging of a perishable product in an atmosphere which has been modified so that its composition is other than that of air. While controlled atmosphere storage, that is CASE, involves maintaining a fixed concentration of gases surrounding the product by careful monitoring and addition of gases, the gaseous composition of fresh MAP foods is constantly changing due to chemical reactions and microbial activity. Gas exchange between the pack headspace and the external environment may also occur as a result of permeation across the package material. The first fresh carcass meat was exported from New Zealand and Australia under CASE in early 1930s. Early developments were generally for storage and transportation of bulk foods. Scientific investigations on effect of gases on extending the shelf life of foods were conducted in 1930 on fresh meat and poultry. Fresh poultry was stored in an atmosphere of 100% carbon dioxide, which was found to considerably extend shelf life. Commercial retailing of fresh meat in MAP tray systems was introduced in the early 1970s. European meat processing and packaging developed during the 1980s with centralized production of MAP meat in consumer packs for distribution to retail outlets. In the past few years, there has been a considerable increase in the range of foods packed in modified atmospheres for retail sale, including meat, poultry, fish, bacon, bread, cakes, crisp, cheese, and salad vegetables. Carcass meat and cooked meat and meat products accounted for 29% and 15% of the total volume of MAP retail foods. The three main gases used in MAP are oxygen, carbon dioxide, and nitrogen. The choice of gas depends on food product being packed. Used singly or in combination, these gases are commonly used to increase shelf life with optimal organoleptic properties of food. Inert or noble gases such as argon are used commercially for products like coffee and snacks. However, the literature on their applications and benefits is limited. Carbon dioxide is a colorless gas with a slight pungent odor at very high concentrations. It is a suffocating and slightly corrosive in the presence of moisture. It dissolves readily in water, 1.57 gram per kg at 100 kPa at 20 degrees Celsius, to produce carbonic acid that increase the acidity of the solution and reduce the pH. It is also soluble in lipids and some other organic compounds. The solubility of carbon dioxide increases with decreasing temperature. Therefore, the antimicrobial activity of carbon dioxide is markedly greater at refrigeration temperature. It has significant implications for MAP of foods. The high solubility of carbon dioxide can result in pack collapse due to the reduction of head space volume. Oxygen is a colorless, odorless, and highly reactive gas which supports combustion. It has a low solubility in water, 0.040 g per kg at 100 kPa at 20 degrees Celsius. Oxygen promotes several types of deteriorative reactions in foods, including fat oxidation, browning reactions, and pigment oxidation. Most of the common spoilage bacteria and fungi require oxygen for the growth. Therefore, to increase the shelf life of foods, the packed atmosphere should contain a low concentration of residual oxygen. Nitrogen is an inert gas with no odor, taste, or color. It has a lower density than air, non-inflammable, and has a low solubility in water, 0.018 g per kg at 100 kPa at 20 degrees Celsius, and other food constituents. Nitrogen doesn't support the growth of aerobic microbes and therefore inhibits the growth of aerobic spoilage, but does not prevent the growth of anaerobic bacteria. The low solubility of nitrogen in foods can be used to prevent pack collapse by including sufficient nitrogen in a gas mix to balance the volume decrease due to carbon dioxide going into solution. Effect of gaseous environment on activity of bacteria, yeast, and molds. A microbial growth is dependent on oxygen to major extent. There are aerobic, microaerophilic, facultative anaerobic, and anaerobic microorganisms. In the table, different spoilage organisms as well as pathogens are listed. The antimicrobial properties of carbon dioxide have been known for some time. More recent work has shown that carbon dioxide is effective against psychrotrophs and has potential for extending the shelf life of food stored at low temperatures. There are several theories regarding the actual mechanism of carbon dioxide action. In general, carbon dioxide increases the lag phase and generation time of microorganisms, and these effects are enhanced at lower temperatures. There appears to be an array of antimicrobial mechanisms, including carbon dioxide lowering pH, inhibition of succinic oxidase at carbon dioxide concentrations greater than 10%. Inhibition of certain decarboxylation enzymes and disruption of the cell membrane. The sensitivity of selected spoilage and pathogenic bacteria to carbon dioxide is shown in the table. The growth of gram-negative bacteria is inhibited more than that of gram-positive bacteria. The effect of carbon dioxide are markedly temperature dependent, and it is therefore imperative that the integrity of temperature control across the supply chain may be maintained. It has been observed that germination of spores of Clostridium botulinum may be stimulated by carbon dioxide. Nitrogen is a relatively inert gas. It is used to displace air and, in particular, oxygen from MAP. Since air and consequently oxygen have been removed, growth of aerobic spoilage organisms is inhibited. It is also used to balance gas pressure inside packs so as to prevent the collapse of packs containing high moisture and fat containing foods, that is meat. Because of solubility of carbon dioxide in water and fat, these foods tend to absorb carbon dioxide from the pack atmosphere. Effect of gaseous environment on the chemical and biochemical properties of food. Lipid oxidation is often called oxidative rancidity and is promoted by oxygen. Oxidative rancidity is a major cause of food spoilage. The reaction of oxygen with unsaturated fatty acids in fat-containing foods is a major cause of deterioration. Oxidation of unsaturated fat is referred to as autooxidation. Since the rate of oxidation increases as the reaction proceeds, hydroperoxide are the predominant initial reaction product of fatty acids with oxygen. subsequent reactions control both the rate of reaction and the nature of the product formed. Some of these products, example, acids and aldehyde, are largely responsible for the off-flavor characteristic of rancid foods. Removal of oxygen and its replacement with nitrogen or carbon dioxide or mixture thereof can inhibit development of rancidity. There are three major pigments in meat: oxymyoglobin red, myoglobin purple, and methemyoglobin brown. The color cycle in fresh meat is reversible and dynamic with constant formation and reformation of three pigments. Brown methemyoglobin, the oxidized or ferric form of the pigment, cannot bind oxygen. The purple myoglobin, in the presence of oxygen, may be oxygenated to the bright red pigment oxymyoglobin, producing the familiar bloom of fresh meat, or it may be oxidized to methemyoglobin, producing the undesirable brown. The conversion of myoglobin to oxymyoglobin or methemyoglobin is dependent on oxygen concentration. Under low oxygen environments, the reduced myoglobin is oxidized to undesirable brown methemyoglobin pigment. Conversely, high oxygen environments favor the formation of oxymyoglobin. The green color of chlorophyll changes to brown gray when oxidized to pheophytin, which is not desirable. The photooxidation of chlorophyll and loss of desirable green color can be significantly reduced by MAP under low oxygen levels and in opaque packages. Oxidative off-flavors can be caused by numerous oxidative reactions in food and drink products. Oxidative warmed over flavor is a characteristic off-flavor preliminary associated with cooked meats and poultry. Commercially, this affects mainly the chilled ready meals and other cooked chill products. In cooked meat and poultry held at chilled storage temperatures, this stale, oxidized flavor may become apparent within a short time. Meat, fish, poultry, beverage, and dairy products are highly susceptible to oxidative processes, which can initiate a chain of reactions resulting in flavor impairment. This can occur relatively quickly. MAP under low oxygen levels can delay the onset of oxidative off-flavors. Because of high solubility of carbon dioxide and its reaction with water to form carbonic acid, there is a potential for some adverse effects on particular foods. These are probably due to the production of localized area of low pH on or near the food surface. Carbon dioxide can combine with myoglobin to form bright red compound carboxymyoglobin, that is similar in color to oxymyoglobin. This compound is much more stable than oxymyoglobin and is one of the reasons why carbon monoxide is toxic. Carbon monoxide also retards fat oxidations and the formation of methemyoglobin. Currently, carbon monoxide is not approved for the use in MAP. Nitrogen is inert and has no direct effect on the chemical and biochemical properties of foods. Plastic packaging materials may consist of a polymer formed from a single plastic, but most MAP films are multi-layer structure formed from several layers of different plastics. Plastic packaging for MAP applications is most commonly found in the form of flexible films for bags, pouches, pillow packs, and top webs, or as rigid and semi-rigid structures for base trays, dishes, cup, and tubs. Commonly used plastic flexible laminates are produced from polyethylene, polypropylene, polyamide, or nylons, polyethylene terephthalate, polyvinyl chloride, polyvinylidene chloride, and ethylene vinyl alcohol. Rigid and semi-rigid structures are commonly produced from polypropylene, polyethylene terephthalate, unplasticized polyvinyl chloride, and expanded polystyrene. The table shows typical plastic-based packaging structures and their applications. Several factors must be considered when selecting packaging materials for MAP applications. Food contact approval. Packaging material in contact with food must not transfer components from the packaging to the food product in amount that could harm the consumer. Gas and vapor barrier properties. Packaging materials for MAP must have the required degree of gas and vapor barrier for the particular food applications. Optical properties. Good optical properties such as high gloss and transparency are essential for the bag, pouch, and top web materials to satisfy consumer demand for a clear view of the product. To provide attractive appearance and shelf impact, some basis tray material are available in various colors which enhance the visual appeal of the product. PET, PP, and EPS trays are supplied in a range of colors. PVC trays are generally used in their natural form to provide a transparent pack. Anti-fogging properties. Condensation, that is fogging, of water vapor on the inner surface of food packs can occur when the temperature of the pack environment is reduced, resulting in a temperature differential between the pack contents and the packaging material. Fogging of the inner surface of leading film is a result of light scattering by the small droplets of condensed moisture that leads to poor product's visibility and aesthetically unpleasing appearance of the pack. This can be overcome by applying anti-fogging agents to the plastic heat sealing layer, either as an internal additive or as an external coating. These chemicals decrease the surface energy of the packaging film, which enables moisture to spread as a thin film across the undersurface of the pack rather than collecting as visible droplets. Anti-fogging agents include fatty acid esters. Most leading materials are available with anti-fog properties, and commonly treated plastic include LDP, LLDP, EVA, and PET. Mechanical properties. Resistance to tearing and puncture and good machine handling characteristics are important in optimizing the packaging operation and maintaining pack integrity during foaming and subsequent handling and distribution. Heat sealing properties. Effective heat seals are essential for maintaining the desired gas composition within the pack. Heat seal quality is dependent on many factors including seal material, seal width, and the machine setting such as temperature, pressure, and dwell time. The function of MAP machines is to retain the product on a thermoformed or preformed base tray or within a flexible pouch or bag. Modify the atmosphere, apply a top web if required. Seal the pack and cut and remove waste trim to produce the final pack. Different types of MAP machines are discussed below. Chamber machines. They are generally used for low production throughout. With preformed pouches through tray machines, the filled pack is loaded into the machine. The chamber closes, a vacuum is created on the pack, and the bag flushes with the modified atmosphere. Heated sealing bars seal the pack, the chamber opens, packs are removed, and the cycle continues. These machines are cheap and easy to operate, but relatively slow and labor intensive. Some chamber machines can handle large packages and are suitable for bulk packs. Snorkel machines. They operate without a chamber and use preformed bags or pouches. The bags are filled and positioned in the machine. The snorkel is introduced into the bag, draws a vacuum, and introduces the modified atmosphere. The snorkels withdraw and the bag is heat sealed. Bag inbox bulk products and retail packs in large MAP master packs can be produced on these machines. Foam fill seal tray machines. Foam fill seal FFS machines form pouches from a continuous sheet of roll stock, floor wrap, or form flexible or semi-rigid tray systems comprising a thermoformed tray within a heat-sealed lid. FFS machines may be oriented in a vertical plan or a horizontal plan. FFS machine using preformed trays or producing thermoformed trays are almost exclusively horizontal machines. Horizontal form fill seal map machines are used extensively in the food industry. Map machines are mainly one of the two techniques to modify the pack atmosphere. Gas flushing. This method employs a continuous gas stream that flushes air out from the package prior to sealing. This method is less effective at flushing air out of the pack, results in residual oxygen level of 2 to 5%. Hence, it is not suited for oxygen-sensitive food products. Generally, gas flushing machines have a simple and rapid operation and therefore a high packing rate. Compensated vacuum gas flushing. This method uses a two-stage process. The evacuation stage, a vacuum is pulled on the pack to remove air. Generally, it is not possible to achieve a full vacuum since reduced pressure will result in water to boil. The vacuum achieved is generally between 5 and 10 mm of Hg. As a general rule, the cooler and drier the food, the lower the achievable vacuum. Gas flushing stage. The pack is flushed with the modified gas mix. The evacuation of air from the pack results in lower residual oxygen levels than that achieved by gas flushing, and therefore this method is better suited for packing oxygen-sensitive products. The two-stage process employed by the compensated vacuum method results in a lower packaging rate than that possible with gas flushing. Sealing. An effective heat seal is critical for maintaining the quality and safety of the packed products. Film factor, thickness and surface treatment, and plastic composition, resin type, molecular weight distribution and presence of additives will determine the machine settings for the sealing operations. The correct combination of time, temperature and pressure of seal bars is necessary to produce a good seal. Insufficient dwell time or temperature can result in ineffective seals that separate at the bond interference. Excessive dwell time or temperature can result in weakness adjacent to the seal area. Cutting. Packs are discharged as a continuous arrangement of filled and sealed packs from a thermoform fill seal machine, and therefore the final operation is to separate into individual packs. This can be carried out by two methods, die cutting and longitudinal and transverse cutting. Die cutting is achieved in one operation. A shaped blade is forced through the film, which is clamped in a place by a frame assembly. Transverse cutting separates packs into rows and is carried out by guillotines or punches, which are driven through the film that is supported by anvils. This may be carried out in conjunction with longitudinal cutting, where circular knives cut through tray flanks parallel to length of the film. Let's discuss about major food which are generally packed under MAP. The major causes of spoilage of raw red meat are microbial growth and oxidation of red oxymyoglobin pigment. The desirable red color of oxymyoglobin pigment has to be maintained by having an appropriate oxygen concentration in the pack atmosphere. At the same time, minimize the growth of aerobic microorganism. Highly pigmented red meats such as venison and wild boar require higher concentration of oxygen. Aerobic spoilage bacteria such as Pseudomonas species normally constitute the major flora on red meats. Since these bacteria are inhibited by carbon dioxide, it is possible to achieve both red color stability and microbial inhibition by using gas mixtures containing 20 to 30% carbon dioxide and 70 to 80% oxygen. These mixtures can extend the chilled shelf life of red meats from 2 to 4 days to 5 to 8 days. A gas product ratio of 2:1 is recommended. Microbial growth, particularly growth of Pseudomonas and Enchromobacter species, is the major factor limiting the shelf life of raw poultry, which are effectively inhibited by carbon dioxide. The inclusion of carbon dioxide in MAP at a concentration in excess of 20% can significantly extend the shelf life of raw poultry products. Carbon dioxide concentration higher than 35% in the gas mixture of retail packs are not recommended because of the risk of pack collapse and excessive drips. Nitrogen is used as an inert filler gas, and a gas product ratio of 2:1 is recommended. Since a pack collapse is not a problem for bulk MAP master packs, gas atmosphere of 100% carbon dioxide are frequently used. It is advisable to maintain refrigeration temperature as some pathogens are not inhibited by carbon dioxide. The principal spoilage mechanisms that limit the shelf life of cooked meat products are microbial growth, color change, and oxidative rancidity. For cooked meat products, the heating process should kill vegetative bacterial cells, inactive degradative enzymes, and fix the color. Hence, spoilage of cooked meat products is preliminary due to post-process contamination by microorganisms. The color of cooked meats is susceptible to oxidation, so low levels of oxygen is maintained in packs. MAP using carbon dioxide nitrogen mixes 25 to 50% carbon dioxide and 50 to 75% nitrogen along with a gas product ratio of 2:1 is widely used to maximize the shelf life and inhibit development of oxidative off-flavors and rancidity. Spoilage of fish and shelf life results from changes caused by three major mechanisms. First, the breakdown of tissue by the fish's own enzyme, autolysis of cell. Second, growth of microorganisms. And third, oxidative reactions. MAP can be used to control mechanism second and third, but has no direct effect on autolysis, which is major cause of spoilage and reduces the effect of MAP. The major spoilage bacteria in processed fish are Pseudomonas, Moraxella, Acinetobacter, Flavobacterium, Cytophaga species, and Clostridium botulinum. Generally, oxygen is included in MAP of white non-processed, that is, non-fatty fish to control the growth of Clostridia. Gas mixture of 30% oxygen, 40% carbon dioxide, and 30% nitrogen are used, but it will not significantly enhance the shelf life of oily or fatty fish. High 40% carbon dioxide mixes along with 60% nitrogen are generally used for smoked and fatty fish. Fresh produce continues to respire after harvesting and produce carbon dioxide, water vapor, and ethane. Ethane promotes ripening and softening of tissues and reduces the shelf life if not controlled. Hence, the goal of MAP for fruits and vegetables is to reduce respiration to extend shelf life while maintaining quality. Respiration can be reduced by lowering the temperature, lowering the oxygen concentration, increasing the carbon dioxide concentration, and by the combined use of oxygen depletion and carbon dioxide enhancement of pack atmosphere. If the oxygen concentration is reduced beyond the critical concentration, anaerobic respiration will be started and produce ethanol, acetaldehyde, and organic acids, which leads to undesirable odors and flavors and a marked deterioration in product quality. While increasing the carbon dioxide concentration will also inhibit respiration. High concentration may cause damage in some species and cultivars. Oxygen concentration below about 3% can induce anaerobic respiration in many species of fresh produce. The use of low concentrations of oxygen and elevated level of carbon dioxide can have a synergistic effect on slowing down respiration and ripening. Major pathogens as far as fresh produce is concerned are L. monocytogens and C. botulinum. L. monocytogenes can grow under reduced oxygen levels and is not markedly inhibited by carbon dioxide and can also grow at lower temperature. Equilibrium map has been used for fresh produce. Essentially, this involves using knowledge of the permeability characteristic of particular packaging films along with the respiration characteristic of the product to balance the gas transfer rates of oxygen and carbon dioxide through the package with the respiration rate of particular product. Increasingly, gas packaging fresh produce along with carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen gas mixtures is being used. The approach may have benefit in reducing enzymic browning reactions before a passively generated equilibrium modified atmosphere has been established. MAP can increase the shelf life of a number of dairy products, that is, whole milk powders, cheese, and fat spreads. Whole milk powder is particularly susceptible to the development of off flavor due to fat oxidation. Commercially, the air is removed under vacuum and replaced with 100% nitrogen or nitrogen carbon dioxide mixes, and the powder is hermetically sealed in metal cans. Cheddar cheese is traditionally vacuum packed. Increasingly, MAP is being used with high carbon dioxide concentration gas mixes. This has the advantage of obtaining a low residual oxygen content and a tight pack due to the carbon dioxide going into the solution. It is important to balance this process using correct nitrogen level in the gas mix so as to avoid excessive pressure being put on the pack seal. Use of nitrogen carbon dioxide atmospheres has significant potential for extending the shelf life of cottage cheese. The cottage cheese is a high moisture, low fat product that is susceptible to a number of spoilage organisms, including Pseudomonas spp. Use of gas mixtures containing 40% carbon dioxide balanced with 60% nitrogen can increase the shelf life significantly.
So in this module, we have covered modified atmosphere packaging and controlled atmosphere packaging and different gases used in MAP and CAP and the product where the MAP and CAP can be applied and the effect of MAP and CAP on the shelf life of the product. Thank you.